Good morning, class.
Good morning, teachers.
Okay, so today we'll present another topic again. I am Kay Martinez Lazar.
I am Andrea Timbreza.
And before I proceed to our discussion proper, let's have first our recap on what we had in the class. By completing this activity. So below are the different online tools. We have the Google Classroom, Test Portal, Zoom, and Canva. And our task is to identify which online tool is being described in each item. Do you understand?
Yes.
Okay, let's start with number one. Who wants to answer? Yes, Mark?
Miss Reed, a tool that gained popularity during the pandemic is presently working as a presentation tool and webinar.
What is the answer? So we use ICT resources So what are the three goals in mathematics again? Yes, Marijon. Give you what one? I give you the three goals. You have
problem solving and critical thinking.
Okay, so problem solving and critical thinking. So through the use of ICT, mas na-develop daw yung dalawang iyon. For instance, the use of simulations, graphing tools, and virtual manipulatives can allow learners to explore mathematical concepts in a more tangible and concrete way. So like for example, yung graphing tool, diba? You want your learners to learn how to plot points in a Cartesian plane. You want learner to graph or to create a shape in the Cartesian plane. So ano yung gagamitin? Yun, yung graphing tools. However, the relevance and appropriateness of ICT resources in mathematics teaching and learning will depend on the learning context. For example, the use of ICT resources may be more suitable for all the learners who have access to technology and comfortable using it. So, hindi lang dapat na grab ka ng grab ng mga ICT resources na hindi mo kinukonsider yung mga estudyante mo. But what if ang babata pa ng mga estudyante mo tapos nag-gumamit ka na ng mga ICT tools or resources, anong mangyayari? Di ba may negative na effect ito sa kanila, lalo pa mga bata pa lang sila. Exposure or excessive exposure to technology tulad sa mga bata is nakakasama. So that's the use. We should balance the use of ICT tools and resources in teaching and learning. So next class is we will discuss assessment and evaluation of ICT resources in mathematics. But before that, what is the difference between assessment and evaluation? Anyone? The difference between assessment and evaluation. None? Okay, Ms. Jana.
The assessment can be done before, during, and after the lesson. And evaluation can be done after or at the end of the course.
Yes, yun yung sinabi ni Ma'am, magsasalin sa atin, di ba? Na assessment is done, can be done before, during, and after the discussion with mo. While evaluation, it is done at the end of the
course.
Learning. And example of evaluation is the summative assessment or yung mga exams, yung mga while the example of assessment and yung recitation, pag yun, since during yun, during the discussion, we also have the quizzes, pagkatapos mismo ng lesson. That is the difference between assessment and evaluation. But aside from that, sino nakakakilala dito kay Carl E. Balita? Who is Carl E. Balita?
Because.
Yes, very good. So he is known for being famous or effective founder ng the CBRC or the Carl Balita Review Center. So back from the topic, sinabi niya na ang assessment and evaluation are almost the same. Nagkakaiba lang sila sa intention. When we talk about assessment kasi, it deals with the process of learning. While evaluation naman, it deals with the product of learning. So ang assessment, ina-assess natin dito sa learning process ito sa mga estudyante. Ina-assess natin yung strength and weaknesses ng ating mga students. While evaluation, dito na yung evaluate na natin yung mga natutunan nila tapos magbibigay na tayo ng grades, di ba? Evaluation. So i-connect natin siya sa ICT resources in mathematics. How to assess and evaluate ICT resources in mathematics teaching and learning. So yun yung pag-aaralan natin. So we have two topics. The first one is assessment of ICT resources in mathematics teaching and learning and evaluation of ICT resources in teaching and learning. So first, ang i-discuss ko ay yung part knowledge is assessment of ICT resources in teaching and learning. How to assess ICT resources in mathematics teaching and learning? So sabi dito, when selecting ICT resources for mathematics teaching and learning, it is important to consider the learning context the curriculum, take note of that, and the learner's need and intended learning outcome. Sabi ko nga kanina, di ba? Hindi lang basta grab ng mga ICT tools or resources para lang kung masabi, ay, nagamit ko to, ang ganda nito, oh, aesthetic. Hindi ganon. You should consider the curriculum, the learner's need, and the intended learning outcome. What if ang ganda nga ng presentation mo or PowerPoint mo, pero yung mga bata, natuto ba? Ayun, yun yung kukosa natin mga teachers. Lalo na tayo, 21st century teachers. Kung huwag tayong mag-focus dun sa content lang mismo, kundi pati sa matututunan ng ating mga students. We need to satisfy their needs, di ba? We need to educate them in order for them to succeed, di ba?
Succeed.
Okay, so I will discuss the different criteria in selecting ICT resources. The first one is relevance to the curriculum. Second, ease of use. Third, accessibility. Fourth, interactivity. And fifth, reliability and quality. So let's discuss it one by one. Mag-focus muna tayo sa relevance of the curriculum. Relevance of the curriculum. So it says here, the ICT resource should align with the mathematics curriculum and support the outcomes of the learning outcomes. So sabi nga kanina, when you are choosing ICT resources, always consider kung mamimit or masasuportahan ba nito yung gusto mong ituro sa mga estudyante. Yung example natin kanina ng graphing tools, you want your students to learn how to plot points on a partition plane. You want them to draw a shape in a partition plane. Then, you want to integrate ICT resources and tools. Choose graphing tools or any tools na pwede silang mag-graph or mag-draw sa partition plane. So that's it. Relevance to the curriculum. Next is ease of use. Who wants to read? Yes, Ms. Dino.
The ICT resource should be easy to use and user-friendly for what the learners can do.
Okay. So other characteristics of a good or ICT resources is ease of use. Ano nga basta ibig sabihin ng ease of use? It is easy to use. Oh, remember that? Madali siyang gamitin sa part mo as a teacher and also sa part ng mga students. Mamili ka ng mga ICT resources na alam mo mismo gamitin or tutukin or manipulahin yung ICT na yun, resources or tools na yun. Huwag kang kukuha ng mga ICT resources na ikaw mismo na teachers hindi mo alam. So ang magiging bunga nun o magiging kalamasan nun, hindi mo maituturo ng mabuti sa mga estudyante kung paano gamitin or paano manipulahin yung ICT tools or resources. So, second, ease of use. Next is accessibility. Yes, Ms. Christine?
The ICT resource should be accessible to all learners, including those with disabilities or special needs.
Okay, so sinabi dito na it should be accessible to all learners. Hindi lang yung ilan or ikaw lang mismo na teacher na ang nakaka-access doon. May mga examples tayo naka-premium, di ba? Afford ba ng mga students mo na mag-premium din? No, di ba? So they can access to that ICT resources or tools na hindi is nagbabayad or naka-premium. So it should be accessible. Third, interactivity. Yes? So the ICT resources should be interactive and engaging. So during online class lab, what are the ICT resources or tools na ginagamit natin in order for us to collaborate, to interact, and to deliver information? We have the quizzes. Any other answers? What are the ICT resources or tools na ginagamit natin para mag-interact?
Google Meet,
tama. So we use Google Meet, like for example, meron tayong group activities, di ba? Doon tayo, ginagamit natin yun to communicate with our members.
The ICT resource should be.
Should be? Can anyone help her? Yes,
the ICT resource should be reliable and valid with accurate mathematical calculations and presentations.
So, paano naman to? The ICT resources or resource should be reliable and valid. Okay, so kapag nagamit tayo ng ICT resources, dapat kapag i-compute natin siya manually or step by step, accurate, basta pareha sila ng sagot. So we should be mindful or kailangan natin mag-consider yun before using that ICT resources. Mayroon naka-round off dito, pero kapag kinumpute mo, ayun na. So it should be reliable and valid. The next part will be discussed as my alternative work.
So since we are done with assessment, we will continue to be evaluating. So please, Mr. Santos.
Next.
So we have to evaluate the ICT resources in mathematics. So first, bago natin i-discuss yan, alamin muna natin yung mga tools na i-evaluate natin. So first one is the rubric. Miss Marie.
A rubric is a scoring guide that provides a clear and consistent way to evaluate the relevance and appropriateness of ICT resources. The rubric can be used to assess the quality of the resources, the level of relevance to the subject matter, and the appropriateness for the
investment. Rubric is very common on us kasi ulit-ulit natin itong dinidiscuss, diba, sa mga iba nating subjects. So, rubric has two types, diba? Yung, what are those?
Holistic and analytic.
So, or analytical. So, sa analytical, who can differentiate those two? Meron ka bang nakakaalala? So, sa analytic or analytical, is two columns lang siya. Ginagawin lang natin siya ng two columns. While the holistic is, meron siya maraming columns. Just like ito, di ba dito yung mga criteria? Pag magagawa tayo ng analytic, pagkara ito yung mga criteria, tapos dito yung percentage. Yung parang, ano ko nga dito, sa relevance of the curriculum, 20%, mga ganun. So, itong mga criteria ang gagamitin mo sa loob ng rubric. So, sa holistic naman, is i-expand mo siya. Kunwari dito sa relevance to the curriculum, isusulat mo siya isa-isa, ease of use. Tapos, lalagyan mo siya ng standards ko. Kunwari, 5 as the highest or nakamit niya ba talaga yung relevance to the curriculum. So, did you get it?
Yes.
So, next is the surveys. Who can read? Miss Jenny.
Surveys can be used to gather feedback from students, teachers, or other stakeholders regarding the relevance and appropriateness of ICT resources. Surveys can provide valuable insights into the usefulness of the resources and how they can be improved.
So surveys, alam na din natin yan because marami nang dumaan sa ating surveys, lalo na nung online class. So here, kunwari ang isang ICT resources is ginamit mo. So one of those tools is surveys, wherein mag-a-answer ka through online ng questions kung gaano ka-effective or gaano ka-useful ang isang ICT tools. So next one is the checklist. Mr. Mark.
Checklists can be used to assess the relevance and appropriateness of ICT resources. A checklist can include items such as the quality of the content, the accuracy of the information, and the appropriateness of the language.
So, I have discussed this also in our subject kay Ma'am Nika. Sa checklist is gagawa ka ng list mo to check, kaya nga checklist. Kung appropriate ba or useful, effective ang isang ICT resources. And the last one is peer evaluation. It's easy.
Peer evaluation can be used to
ensure the use of ICT resources during the lesson and take notes on the learner's engagement, understanding, and performance.
So observation, it is parang understandable naman na sa observation na the teacher will observe the learners on how they manipulate the assessment tool kung nakakatulong ba sa kanilang engagement, sa kanilang understanding, and kanilang performance. And the next one is learner's feedback. Yes, Mr. Ramos.
Learner feedback. The learner should be asked to provide feedback on their experience of using the ICT resource, including ease of use, interactivity, and use.
So learner's feedback is parang sa surveys din kami na liba. Diba sa surveys, sinabi ko kanina niya kung gaano sila satisfied sa ginamit nilang assessment. So dito, learner's feedback is parang ganun din, nagbibigay sila ng feedback on ease of use or ito ba ay madaling gamitin, interactivity, and yung kanyang usefulness. And the next one is assessment of learning outcomes. So dito na, di ba kanina may learning outcomes tayo? So dito na, i-assess mo kung na-meet mo ba or na-achieve mo ba talaga yung learning outcomes. So just like din sa mga LPs natin or sa mga demonstration natin, kung na-attain mo ba ang iyong learning outcomes. So the last one is the reliability and validity. The assessment should be reliable and valid with accurate assessment of the learner's performance. So, kaya din kasi nasa criteria sa reliability and validity. So, you need to test also kung reliable ba talaga yung mga reference or mga answers na nasagot sa isang question. So, always remember that by using the above criteria and assessment tool, teachers can ensure that the ICT resources being selected for mathematics, teaching, and learning are relevant. So, sa mga gagamitin natin na yung mga na-discuss namin, so, always think as a teacher na yung relevant ng assessment tool na gagamitin natin. Of course, wala naman itong matuturan kung hindi naman relevant sa ating topic ang ginamit nating assessment tool. And of course, the appropriateness or the appropriate and effective in supporting the learning outcomes of their learners in the given learning context. So, thank you for
your activity class, you will create a rubric about assessing and evaluating ICT resources.
Analytics.
Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analytics. Analyt